Romans chapter 12 and Proverbs chapter 21. Romans chapter 12 is one of my memory chapters. And in many ways, to me, Romans chapter 12 is kind of a Proverbs of the New Testament. It's one of those chapters that every little line is sort of a different thought and a different word of encouragement and kind of breaks up into a lot of little subjects. But in the middle section, this part about gifts, I don't know if you know this, but Romans chapter 12 is one of the most often taught chapters in all the Bible because of the gifts section. Verse 4 says, just as each of us has one body with many members, and these members do not all have the same function. Then it goes on in verse 6, we have different gifts according to the grace. And that word grace means joy inside you. And it goes on, it says, if a man's gift is prophesying, let him use it in proportion to his faith. If it is serving, let him serve. If it is teaching, let him teach. If it is encouraging, let him encourage. If it's contributing needs of others, let him give generously. If it is leadership, let him govern diligently. If it is showing mercy, let him do it cheerfully. And it just reeks of this joyous connectivity that everybody finds something that fits them on the inside. It shouts that living the Christian life is fun, that God has this little fingerprint of personality, that there's going to be something for you that you go, ooh, I just love that. Ooh, it just burns on the inside of me. And it's such a loud statement of the lightheartedness of God and the fun of God and the uniqueness of God that he says, I'm going to find something for you to do in my body that you just love. So I love Romans chapter 12 because it's about what a joyful place it is in the kingdom of God and what a generous God we have who loves to flow joy through us. Now, Proverbs chapter 21, let's go ahead and hit verse 5 because this is a real awakening verse to me. I joke with my staff that I've never been guilty of going too slow. I've been guilty many times of going too fast. And that's why I say, if you want to hear the voice of God, know the bent or the leaning. So if I think that the Spirit of God is saying move faster, it might be God, but it really might not be God. But if I say God is moving slower, it's always God because my personality is to go fast, fast, fast. So I tend to notice verses that talk about fast. They awaken me. They say, okay, John, pay attention. So verse 5 talks about fast. And it says, the plans of the diligent lead to profit. As surely as haste, ooh, there's me again. Hurry, 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 hurry. Get it done yesterday. Get it done now. Lead to poverty. And the thing I noticed here is the opposite of hurry, in fact, I wrote this down, is not moving slow. And sometimes people like me that are always in a hurry, we can be judgmental and say, well, okay, so I can't move fast. That means I have to move slow. And the Bible says, no, 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 no. The opposite of fast is not slow. The opposite of fast is, are you ready? Steady. And that's pretty calming. That's pretty encouraging. It says the plans of the steady, the plans of the diligent, the plans of those who just keep moving at a steady pace lead to profit. And that's helped me sometimes to say, I don't have to stop. I just need to move steady, not at a racehorse pace. So I hope that helps you today. May the Lord guide you in a steady, diligent pace that brings profit to your day today. God bless you. Have an awesome day.